try and swim next door to the willow, and as you can see there's some ripples on the water because we've just had a carp roll down here. That's a good sign, it means they're moving this way probably. Whenever you see fish rolling around this area, it's always a good idea to get in the willows. So that is a good sign. I'm pleased about that. Yeah, there's an awful lot of weed floating around on the surface there. It's absolutely chocker with weed round here. Big old weed bed out there as well. Always used to be. And there's a carp over there. Focus please. On the surface. A couple of them actually. And the weeds really come up out there actually. I haven't noticed that before. But the weed beds all around here have really, really come up. Big time. So I think I better start exploring those areas because carp are obviously going to spend a lot of time in that area. This has always been the weediest part of the lake. This is always the area where the weed tends to get sort of floor to ceiling. Another carp out there on the top. I was a bit afraid of this. With all that sunshine, the fish just topped just there. So, we've got plenty of activity. Yeah, with that bloody sunshine there, you see, that will put the carp on top. It's not what you want, is it? Let's get back to the swim. Well, Mr. Sunshine's still out a little bit, but I'm really hoping that that bank of cloud that's coming from the south-southwest moving in this direction, slowly but surely, it's going to blot him out. Because the net result of him being out is that the fish go up. And of course, I have to change all my setup, take all my rigs out that have taken a lot of care and a lot of preparation to put in, and then go float a fishing. And to be honest with you, that's not worth it here, especially when there's only a few of them up and they're right out in the middle, you know. There's a couple of three fish over there that have been up for the last half an hour. And like I say, if we can get a bit of a wind on this bloody lake, then we'd like to be in business. But at least if that sunshine gets blotted out by all that cloud, then I'll be a little bit happier with the conditions. The weather forecast was for similar conditions to yesterday. A lighter wind, but overcast and a bit of rain. That suits me, because the fish certainly responded to that yesterday. I'm disappointed actually that I didn't get a fish yesterday. Well, and you're always disappointed, aren't you, when you blank. But, well, I've come to learn that, you know, there are a lot of days go by here when, you know, not only do you not catch a fish, but sometimes you don't even see one. But generally speaking, you get a few shows each day. But you can't rely on the conditions or the shows to dictate where you're going to fish. Sometimes you just have to do it on gut instinct and accumulated knowledge, really. And that was what I was trying yesterday. To be honest with you, I think I should have stayed in the fields, mate. I should have stopped here actually and set up here, which I've done this morning. Let's see if it pays off. But I should have stayed in the fields, mate, really. Who knows what that guy put in the night before. Certainly with my mate Kev pre-baiting, he said he was putting loads in the shallows, so I don't know. Yeah, there could be load laying around still if they haven't been in there munching it. I haven't seen the tufty or coot activity over the shallows that much, which would indicate that there isn't anything there, really. But there you go. They certainly are active on my spots over there though, and have been all morning. I put some hemp in yesterday, but nothing since then, yesterday afternoon. Of course I put some in here last night, I haven't put any bait in this morning except little bags and about six baits around each hook bait, and that is it. Any fish that come in here, I want them to pick up my hook bait. I don't care if they feed or not, I just want them to pick up my hook bait. And I've got more chance of that the less bait there is in the swim. They won't be drawn into the swim because of my bait, that's for sure. They'll be drawn into this swim because they want to be in here, or because other people have been putting bait in on a regular basis. But it ain't my bait that's attracting them. But they do like it, and they will scoff it if they come across it. So that's why it's important to put your bait in exactly the right spots so that the carp do come across it. Ta-ta, Mr. Sunshine. Now hopefully it won't clear from the west. Because that's lovely, isn't it? Look at that. That's a bit of rain. And high above us too, bit of rain there. And look at those lovely clouds on the horizon. Aren't they great? Especially that bit there. Look at that dark area. There's some rain in there. Whee! So conditions are looking good, and we've just had another show, much closer this time. Yes, out in front of the fields, usual area. So they'll be coming in here soon, I'm quite sure of that. Because that fish topped only 20 yards away from where my bait is, and I know where it's heading in this bay, mate. So I've got three baits in position. One of those will fly off soon and I will get myself a nice big fat carp. That would be so good. Well, that's the second show in the last few minutes. A very nice 20 mirror. And as you can see, it ain't far off where I'm fishing. When you see fish rolling out there, it's time to get in the willows. I definitely think I'm in the right spot. The sunshine hasn't been beaten back. In fact, the sunshine has beaten back the cloud. I can't believe it. All that heavy, thick cloud just disappeared. There's more on the western horizon, but hardly any. So the weather forecast is wrong. But there you go. I don't really care when I'm seeing fish rolling out there like that. I know I'm in the right spot. I'm bloody glad I came in here this morning. I'm glad I'm not sitting over in the shallows. Right hand rod. What the hell? What the hell? I think maybe that was a liner. Because unfortunately there's weed and crap all the way between me and where my bait is on that right hand rod. And that fish could have picked up. Could be a fish moving through and picking up the line. Yeah, I am back-leaded, but yeah. So there you go. That was either a liner or getting dumped. I think it's probably a liner because the bobbin went straight up and straight down. Normally when you get done, the bobbin goes up quite fast and normally stays there. So we're getting activity. There's definitely a chance we can get a flapper on the bank today. Definitely a chance. I just hope it's a real big one, not a double one. Never know, I might get two. Come on. I thought I was going to have to put the video camera down then on the chair. I thought that might roar off. Never mind, eh? Good sign. Means there's fish in the swim.